All right, friends. Well, we're fixing to get after it again here. I'm going to try anyway. When the guys came out here and did the clearing work, they left this pile in the way. Or at least from what I can gather pacing it out, it's in the way. And this burn pile is sitting right about where I believe the garage is going to go. And that's not going to work. So, I've got an excavator on the way. It's technically a Mini-X, but it's a bigger one. It's a Komatsu TB250, which I think is about equivalent to a John Deere 50D on the excavator size. But it's got a hydraulic thumb on it and you know, a little bit more horsepower, a little bit more reach, all those good things. So, anyway, I'm just climbing up here on top of my little mountain. I think I'm... I'm up here standing probably at the highest point in about a mile radius, at least, to be my guess. Definitely the highest point on my property. But anyway, see the pile here? This is in the original burn pit, so there's a hole underneath there. That'll be my first goal, be to get that out. Try to find me some older, drier wood to work with. And I've got to start moving it all back over here in the corner and just repiling it and trying to burn it. So certainly got a big project ahead of me, and starting to second guess this idea, but we'll see. We'll try. We'll give it a shot. And yeah, we'll get it moved over there and get it lit up and try to get it to burn. I brought a few toys along to help me burn. Here, I'll go show those to you. All right, so the first and arguably the best is a weed burner, or to put it simply, redneck blowtorch. So this will give me plenty of heat, plenty of fuel to try to get some stuff lit up and going. I've also got two jugs, which plan to use the diesel to run the machine, but I might have to resort to using some of it to fuel the fire. But anyway, blowtorch is my first toy to help out, and then the second toy is my leaf blower. A lot of people wouldn't necessarily think about that. They think, well, hey, if you want a fire to burn, you probably shouldn't want to blow it out, should you? But you know, once you get a fire going good, or even when you've got a good bed of coals, being able to put the air to it really makes a big difference on being able to get it to burn really good. And so what I'm going to try to do is get me a little pile. I'll actually go ahead and get it started now. The guy with the excavator just called me and said he's about an hour out. Go figure. So I'm going to try to get a little pile going now and try to get it lit up and, you know, be able to use the weed burner and the leaf blower, try to get it going good and hot so that hopefully by the time that excavator gets here, I'll already have a good base going and start stacking onto it. But I don't know, we'll see. Probably none of this is going to work, but hopefully it will. Well, we're getting a start at it. At least getting a little brush pile started here. You know, this is nothing compared to that big monster, but you got to start somewhere. So some of you guys may recognize the tool I'm using here. This is my weed burner. And honestly, you know, one of these tanks of propane can cost you maybe 20 bucks. And it can burn at a rate like this for probably an hour or more. So I've just got my weed burner shoved up under there for a pilot light. And I'm piling on bigger and bigger twigs as fast as I can to try to get a fire. Excavator should be here any minute. And just as soon as it is, I'll start really adding some bigger stuff to the fire. But for right now, we're just got ourselves a little campfire going. Looking good.
Well, I'll just cut to the chase and give you all the sad, crappy news. What you're looking at right there in the middle of the picture is a busted pin. And that's the main pin that runs through where the thumb, here's my thumb, and here's the bucket. Where the thumb and the bucket both connect to the end of the arm right there, that pin sheared clean through on two sides. So it runs all the way through here, all the way through the end of the arm, and then through the other side of the thumb there. Busted clean through. So I really didn't think that I had it in a bind. You know, I was reaching down in one of the holes where they were trying to burn in the past, and just trying to pull logs up and out of there, and I guess just because of the angle, one of the logs was hung up or something. I heard a pop and noticed that the thumb and the bucket kind of went limp and did their own thing, got away from each other. So that's it. I'm done. This was probably $1,000 flushed down the drain, because I doubt they're going to be real nice to me. I called the 24-hour helpline for what it's worth, and the technician just told me, he's like, well, yeah, it's busted. He's like, I can send a repair tech, and he can look at it and tell you it's
busted, but we don't keep the extra pins in stock, so there's nothing we can do as far as getting it repaired tonight or anything else. He's like, we're going to have to order parts. So I think I managed to put about 3 hours on the engine out of the 8 that I paid for. Maybe they'll comp me, but I really doubt it. I think they're probably going to tell me tough luck. Anyway, lesson learned on these little mini X's. I mean, this one is it's a bigger mini X, and it did pick up the logs and move them, no problem. But these things, you know, it still had to be real careful, and apparently even that wasn't enough. So these little things just aren't big enough for doing this kind of work. I'm going to have to get a bigger one out here. So I guess I'll call the rental company and just the rental company that's got the bigger ones up here and just kind of ask them to see about putting one on hold when they get one in, or put my name on a list to get one when they get it, and we'll go from there. But yeah, pretty much made no progress. No, I'm not happy.